over the last 2 weeks or so to fast track this process of approval. And also on behalf of the Kenyan people, to thank Google Loon for offering this service initially without levying any charges, for this is what true partnership between the government and the private sector means. We are currently also working on other initiatives to support our private sector during this particular difficult time. Most importantly, to ensure that they are able to continue to pay our hardworking Kenyans who have been employed by them. But we would also encourage that our companies and businesses do also that which they can to work with us and to support government during this particular period. The use of technology will increasingly become important. Only yesterday, the Kenyatta Diagnostic Center here at Kenyatta Hospital, where we have the CT scan center,
8 minutes ago,
we did, and it was the first to happen on the African continent using technology. They were able to remotely conference with three centers in China and in Egypt, another in France, and also with Eldoret Moi Referral Teaching Hospital, where they were able to exchange with professionals and clinical officers across the world to share both experiences and practical ways in which we can defeat this virus that is upon us. So the use of technology will continue to be increasingly important as we move forward. More updates on the state, or our current state of the virus, will be given later by the Ministry of Health in their regular daily briefings. But at this juncture, I cannot but continue to emphasize the need for each and every one of us to follow the protocols that have been laid out by the Ministry of Health. Most importantly, with regard to the danger posed to our population by people who flagrantly refuse to adhere to the laid down protocols, I want to once again and categorically reaffirm that the government will take the severest action against any individual who knowingly breach these laid down conventions and procedures, and in turn put the rest of the population at risk. So I encourage you, each and every one of you, let us follow the guidelines as has been given by the Ministry of Health. Let us be our brother's keeper, let us be our sister's keeper, and I am sure that if we do this, we shall overcome this particular pandemic. As I said, in a few days' time, we shall also be having a further session with private sector, where we shall be announcing a raft of measures that the government will take to support our businesses and to support our people during this particularly difficult time. I thank you all, and thank you all for coming.